Hi, in the last video, we got our app dockerized, and now we are ready to deploy it to the cloud for free. But before we proceed, let's quickly recap what we have accomplished in this series so far. In part 1, we set up FastAPI project for the backend. Then in part 2, there was MongoDB setup. After this, we implemented core connect 4 logic. Then we finished the backend by developing API and WebSocket endpoints. In part 5, we set up Next.js project for the frontend and created all the needed pages. Then, in part 6, we improved the frontend with local storage usage, column highlighting, black theme, game replayability, and responsive design. And finally, in part 7, we set up Docker for the application. That was for the past. Now today, we will set up Google Cloud Platform, Cloud Run, and Docker Hub for the backend. Then use MongoDB Atlas to set up the database. After this, we'll leverage the same Cloud Run and Docker Hub but for the frontend. And finally, check how our application works in the cloud. Let's start with the Google Cloud Platform. Please open this URL and use your Gmail account to log in. Once it's done, you'll be redirected to the welcome page. Now let's create a project here. For this, click Select the project and tap New Project button. I'll call it BetProject Connect 4. Then click Create. Now let's check our project. Don't feel overwhelmed by the number of sections and configurations. We won't really need them all. Alright, we're done with the Google Cloud Platform preparation, now let's go to the Docker Hub. Here we also need an account, I'll just use my Gmail in the sign up. Once you are done, you'll be redirected to the Welcome to Docker page. Let's go to the repositories. For now, we don't have any, but don't worry, we'll create one soon. One more thing, yurochkadev that is shown on the page is the username I set during sign up. Now please open Docker Desktop and log in using a created account. We are ready to deploy our backend. We will build a Docker image where our name is yurochkadev/betprojectconnect4backend and tag is 100. We can see the created image in the Docker desktop. Now we run Docker login command. Then we'll push our created Docker image to the Docker Hub. Now, in the Docker Hub, if we reload the page, we can see our image. The tag in our version 100 is also specified here. Now, let's go back to the Google Cloud Platform. To create Cloud Run services and deploy our application to the cloud, we need a billing account. As my Google Cloud account is brand new, I can use the free trial. If you don't have this option, don't worry, Google Cloud Platform has a free tier. Basically, if your Cloud Run services will have fewer than 2 million requests per month, you shouldn't be charged anything. I will leave the link to the free tier usage limits in the description so you can check it out. But again, for the new accounts, there is free trial opportunity, so we'll go with it. Once you're done, let's open Cloud Run and click Create Service button. Then I'll specify container image URL, it will be an image from Docker Hub. Then service name, BetProject backend. The region will be a default value, we'll allow unauthenticated invocations, we won't change the rest. Then let's go to the container config. We will set port to be 8000 as it's specified in the Docker file. We will leave command empty as the command from the Docker file will be run. Let's reduce the memory. Then let's specify environment variables, we will reuse our .env file for this. We will reduce request timeout and maximum concurrent request per instance. We'll set maximum number of instances to 1. Let's uncheck the CPU boost. And create our service. and we've got an error. Let's go to the logs to check what's wrong. There is some poetry exec format error. After some research, I found that it relates to building Docker images on M1 chip. If you don't have this issue, that's fine, you can switch to the next step. And if you do, don't worry, we'll fix it now. To fix it, when we build a Docker image, we should specify a Linux platform. Also, let's bump up a version. Now we will push this image to the Docker Hub. In the Docker Hub, we can see our new version. Now, let's redeploy our Cloud Run service. We need to update container image URL. And the build is successful. Let's go to the deployed backend URL, and we can see our hello pet project world. Here it is in the code. Let's visit our API docs. If you try to list games, it won't work. That's because of the MongoDB. We didn't deploy it yet, and for now, in the environment variables, we set it to localhost. Let's check our logs. And we can see our internal server error. In the logs, it's timeout error due to localhost. Alright, let's deploy our MongoDB. For this, let's go to the MongoDB Atlas. Similarly to the Google Cloud Platform and Docker Hub, we need an account. I'll use my Gmail to create one. Right after registration, you'll be redirected to the deploy cluster page. Let's choose a free option. The name will be Pet Project Cluster. Provider will be Google Cloud, and the region will be the same as our Cloud Run services. Then we'll click Create Deployment. By default, your current IP address will be added to the white list. Let's remove it in the network access. On the overview page, we'll click Connect button. In the IP address section, we'll allow access from anywhere. After this, we'll create a database user. Please save the credentials somewhere. Now you may see the connection string. Let's check it in the MongoDB compass. When we connect using this connection string, it's working fine. We can see the default databases and some sample from MongoDB Atlas. Let's use this connection string in our Cloud Run environment variables. The deployment is successful. If you go to the API docs, list games return empty list. If you try to create a game, it's working as expected. Let's check our created game from MongoDB Compass. Now there is that project database, games collection in it, and our created game. If you create another game, it also will be shown in MongoDB Compass. So, our MongoDB setup is finished. We deployed it and our Cloud Run backend service is using it. Now, we may switch to the frontend. Let's build our frontend image. As we already know from the backend issue, we should specify a Linux platform. Then we run docker login command. After this, push our image to the Docker Hub. If we reload Docker Hub, we can see our frontend image. Now let's create a Cloud Run service for the frontend. Service name will be pet project frontend. After this, we specify an image URL. We will allow unauthenticated invocations. In frontend Docker file, we specified port as 3000, so we need to update it in the Cloud Run. Then we reduce memory. Then we will specify environment variables within frontend.env file. Then we reduce request timeout and maximum concurrent requests per instance. Maximum number of instances will be 1, and we will remove this startup CPU boost. And that's it, we may create our service. The frontend is deployed, let's check it out. If we try to create a game in the network, we can see an error. That's because we are sending requests to localhost 8001, as it's specified in the environment variables. But our deployed backend has a different URL, so we need to use it in our frontend Cloud Run service. Let's update the environment variables. When we send the request now, we get a course error. That's because of the backend environment variables. At the moment, we allow requests from localhost 3000, but our frontend has different URL now. So let's update our backend Cloud Run service. After we redeployed the backend, let's go back to the frontend. The game is created successfully, but we have another error. According to the console, an insecure WebSocket connection may not be initiated from a page loaded over HTTPS. So, our backend and frontend are using HTTPS, but in the frontend environment variables, we specified WebSocket URL as WS and not WSS. The difference is that WSS sets up a WebSocket over an encrypted TLS connection, while WS uses an unencrypted connection. So let's update the WebSocket environment variable and then redeploy the frontend service. And now everything is working. So let's play our final Connect4 game in this series. Congratulations, you successfully finished a pet project. Thank you for joining me on this adventure. It was quite a journey, right? I really hope you learned something new and found inspiration for your own project. As for this one, if you are keen on further enhancing it, here are some ideas. You could create a game history page to display a list of played games. Implement authentication to save players' game data and show statistics. Enhance error validation and display error messages on the frontend. Add multiplayer feature where people can watch the game and leave comments in some chat. Integrate social features such as friends and followers. The possibilities are endless. Feel free to share your feedback on this video series and your ideas for future content. Hopefully, we'll meet on this channel again. Have a fantastic day. Bye.